would, please refrain from taking any further pictures during service. Simply settle back and enjoy this wonderful moment with these two. We're assembled here in the presence of God to join Amy and Tyler in holy marriage, which is instituted of God, regulated by His commandments, blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ, and to be held in honor among us all. Let us therefore reverently remember that God has established and blessed marriage for our joy. Our Savior has declared that a man and woman will leave their families and embrace each other. And by His apostles, He's instructed those who enter into this relationship to cherish a mutual esteem, care, and love, to bear with each other's infirmities and weaknesses, to comfort each other in times of trouble, sorrow, and illness, to provide for each other and for your household in ordinary ways, and then to pray for and encourage each other in the things which pertain to God. Now, we had some enjoyable conversation as we were preparing for the service, and I simply want to commend you to life, because I know that you know what a lot of us know, and that is life is God's good gift to us all. And let us bow our heads in prayer. Gracious God, you are always faithful in your love for us. Look mercifully upon Amy and Tyler, who have come seeking your blessing. Let your Holy Spirit rest upon them, so that with steadfast love they may honor the promises they make this day, through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Now, you've chosen as a scriptural text for your wedding, and I assume it's really for your life. And it's a familiar one. It comes from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, Paul's letter on love. And he says this: love is patient, it is kind, love is not envious or boastful, arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way, it is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. And now faith, hope, and love abide, these three, and the greatest of these is love. Now there's more in the text, but maybe you can all just take a look at chapter 13 of Paul's letter, but we went to kind of the heart of it in this moment. It's my understanding that in the Greek language, there are at least three different words for love. Eros, from which we get the idea of we find others attractive to us. Kind of beautiful lady. Handsome fellow. That's Eros. Thanks be to God for Eros, that we should find others attractive to us. Then there's Phidias. Phidias is the word for friendship love, or between brothers and sisters, parents and their children, between good friends. If I have any spare time on my hands, I want to spend it with you. That's Phidias love. City of Philadelphia gets its name, city of brotherly and sisterly affection. How many of you have been to Philadelphia? Can I see your hands? Oh, quite a lot of you. Did you not notice while there in Philadelphia that the people were much more outgoing and friendly and polite? Not really. It's still a wonderful idea. You know, we should find ourselves in a community of people where people are really neighborly. Share lawnmowers and all kinds of other things, and just reach out and care about each other. So it's a wonderful word, philias. When Paul is writing, he's not using either of these two terms. He's using a third word. The first two are based on emotion. This one is based on the will. This one says, I will love you. even though right now it's a bit of a struggle. It's called agape love. It, in fact, is the word that is used to describe the essential nature of God in Scripture. God is love. It is a willful, self-giving kind of love. You see, one of the difficulties in even in the best of relationships is that we may pledge ourselves to love each other and pledge all kinds of things, but we're sometimes kind of weak in the knees or weak in the head or something, and we don't quite always follow through on the way we ought to be. Now, I'm going to make a confession, a public confession right now. I'm in my 50th year with my wife, dear wife. If we can make it to September the 8th, we will have accomplished 50 years together. And we're that close, and it looks like we're going to make it. But one of the things that happened from earliest years is that I discovered I married a woman with a photographic memory. Actually, not only photographic, but audio memory. Because she can remember back to those very earliest years things that I said and did and do a verbatim. She can quote me without any hesitation and remind me of the way I was. Now, maybe some of the other gentlemen in the room here have wives like that. You'll know what we've endured together because you live with a woman with that kind of gift. You certainly, over a period of time, learn to kind of straighten out your life. Fly right, or at least you try to. And this is what agape is about. Because agape says, I'm going to love you even when you fall short of what I have in terms of expectations. Now, there's a marvelous thing I have noticed, and I have 6 children, so I've seen it all happen. We tend to love our children, do we not, before they're perfect. Have you noticed how that works? We love our children before they're perfect, and it is the way we are loved by God. That is what this text is suggesting to us. So you have chosen a wonderful text for your marriage, because it certainly is going to be helpful to you as you are reminded you have eros and philios for each other, but you also have agape, which is patience, kindness, not envious or boastful, arrogant or rude towards each other. You're not just going to insist on your own way. You're not going to be irritable or resentful. It is a kind of love that helps you get through all those things that try to crowd us with things that want to take us down. And it helps us, verse 7, to bear all things, to believe all things, to hope all things, to endure all things. A great text for your life together. Good choice. Now, I have 2 questions. Who presents Amy to Mary Tyler?
Her mother and I.
Thank you. And who presents Tyler to Mary Amy?
His mother and I.
Thank you. I think they're turning out pretty well, wouldn't you say? Probably every single person here has some reason why they're here, because they've had an influence for good in your lives. That's why you invited them to come. And if you have a sense of why you're important to them, you can just take great satisfaction this day in this day and what is happening here. And in fact, if you want to, you can take some credit for how well they're turning out. But we're going to give special recognition to some folks that really have made a difference in their lives. And we can do that right now. Thank you. kinds of things that happens when I meet with couples to prepare for a service like this is they give me a list of things that they value in each other, words and phrases that are expressive of the things that really matter to them. And you gave me a nice list, and I said I was going to convert those words and phrases into a set of questions. The answer to the three questions that I've composed is I do. And if we get the three I do's, we'll continue with the service. Tyler and Amy, do you intend to grow together in your faith and family commitment? Do you?
I do.
Do you pledge to love and honor each other? Do you? And do you intend to continue living by the values of loyalty, good communication, mutual support, and good humor? Okay, and now, a more traditional declaration of intent on your part. Tyler, will you have Amy to be your wife, and will you pledge your faithfulness to her in all love and honor, duty and service, faith and tenderness, to live with her and to cherish her according to the ordinance of God and the holy bond of marriage? Will you?
I will.
And Amy, will you take Tyler to be your husband, and will you promise in covenant before you pledge your faithfulness to him in all love and honor, duty and service, faith and tenderness, to live with him and to cherish him according to the ordinance of God in the holy bond of marriage? Will you? And now, facing each other for your vow. Tyler, you get to speak first your vow of love and affection for me before God and all these witnesses out here. Are you ready? Are you ready?
Yes, I am.
Good. Looking right at her, what a pleasure. I, Tyler.
Hi, Tyler.
Take you in.
Take you in.
To be my wife.
You are.
And I promise and covenant.
Before God and these witnesses,
to be your loving husband, in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as we are in shadow. Tokens of your love. The rings. Okay. Now, it is my habit to look very carefully at the rings because these are powerful symbols of an intention of the mind and heart. And I want to make sure that the jeweler, in bonding these bands of precious metal, has not left a point of weakness or something. So I'm going to get a little help. Would you give me your opinion? Boy, you're quick. Oh, that's right. You had them on your finger. I always get a second opinion, so we're going to go over here and you give me your second. They look pretty good to you, too. Okay. Well, I think that's fine. We can proceed. It's my understanding that in all cultures, the whole world over, the circle has been used to describe wholeness, completeness, fullness. It's found in the arts, particularly in the mandala, the circle, you know, that is representing all of life. The yin-yang symbol, you've seen that, other things of that sort. And this is true then these are powerful representations of an intention on both your parts to help the other person become whole, complete, fully alive to all the qualities, all the possibilities, all the characteristics that are buried within that person, which need to be released to find full expression. Now that is your assignment for life. As you give the ring, and as you receive the ring, 10 days from now, 10 years from now, 50 years from now, your assignment is to help the other person become that person that God has gifted that person with the capacity to be. So, understanding your assignment, in a loving way, you are to be reminding yourself as you see that ring, how am I doing? And help. Now, if you do your job really well on behalf of the other person, you'll live with the most fascinating person in the world, and you'll never be bored with each other, which is one of the reasons why so many people have difficulties in their marriage. So, let's ask God's blessing on that intake. Gracious God, we thank you for what you make possible in our lives. We ask that you will help Tyler and Amy live far beyond this day's imaginings, that they may fulfill what they have agreed to do on behalf of each other to help the other person become whole, complete, fully alive to all of the gifts they've been given through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Taking her ring. This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
In token and pledge.
Of our constant faith
and abiding love,
and abiding love.
In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
This ring I give you, in token and pledge of our constant faith. And abiding love, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. If you just go to the room. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Gracious God, we thank you for what we have observed between these two. Behind all the love that's afloat in this room this day is your love that makes possible our love for each other far beyond our imagining. Now we've brought with us on this occasion wedding gifts. We brought with us spiritual wedding gifts, loving thoughts, hopes, dreams, expectations for the journey of life these two will share. And we offer now an opportunity as we bring our gifts in a quiet, prayerful way, inviting you to gather up our gifts and make them available as these two have need of them in that wonderful journey that they have ahead. And so in a moment of quietness now, we bring our gifts. Not only the words that have come to mind or the thoughts that we've had. For you know us and love us and care for us at a place of deep mystery beyond our inner longings and yearnings for life and love as it at its deepest level. And you help us to understand and join each other at that place of deep mystery. So out of gratitude for the intimacy that you make possible, We offer now a prayer, a familiar prayer, as we say these words together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Tyler. Amy. It is my great pleasure to announce that you are husband. You should see this smile. And wife. And joining your hands together, whom God has joined together now with cords of love and a promise, let no one separate. The Lord bless and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace, especially this day, that your whole life long. Now, if you would like to make that blessing your blessing upon them as well, we use a small word with a powerful meaning. Amen. It means, let it be. Let the blessing be. So if you choose to do so, join me with some energy in saying,
Amen.
And now you may rise. Now, most couples at this time in the service have sort of given some thought as to how they might give expression, feelings, and affection. Sometimes we see a kiss, sometimes a hug, sometimes several each. We'll just enjoy watching the kiss. Present to you now in this public setting for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Tyler and Amy Sullivan, husband and wife.
Thank you. That would be a the saying isn't a big deal. It's after the laugh, after that you realize.
Service, I'd like to invite up Amy's father, Mark, for our blessing. Mark.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, I just want to thank you for bringing Tyler and Amy together in a way only you can do. Lord, I just ask that you bless this day. And I'm just thankful for such a wonderful day, such a beautiful day to have a wedding. Lord, you have blessed us, blessed our children, and we thank you for that. Lord, we thank you for all the blessings that you've poured on us, and the least of which is our children, and the just the wonderful adults that they've grown into. Lord, we just thank you for this time together. We thank you for the whole family that's been gathered here to celebrate this wonderful time. And we just ask that you would bless this gathering and bless this food as we celebrate with Amy and Tyler their first day of marriage. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Thank you.
6 o'clock.
Yeah. How do you like the weather? It's great. It's a different feel than like our BMW, but for what it is, it's very good. It's very fast. Yeah. 0 to 60 in like 5 seconds.
I don't remember growing older.
Someone
Go ahead.
Yay!
I was like, what are they going?
Hey!